new year,
same old Workbench. Hey everybody out there on YouTube, this is Cheetah Wolf. It feels so weird to say that again after it being so long since I've done a video like this.
A few things have changed on the workbench. I think I mentioned it before, but over there I got an improved power supply. I've also got a new sort of soldering station for Christmas. I'm hoping to get into more, I guess, fine electronics. I even got this freaking world's cheapest desoldering pump that came with my soldering station. Now here's the thing. As it stands right now, the raw video here is being recorded in portrait, but I'm going to try and flip it to landscape and editing, so things are probably going to look a little bit weird for this first one. Also got this China Deluxe mat down here that's just so great. Subject of today's video is going to be this. Actually, I got to hold it like this so it makes sense on the video. It's gonna be confusing for a while. This random lot box of $500 to $1,000 value, open box. The description basically says you're getting scammed. And for some reason, I don't know why, eBay wants to freaking recommend me like water cooling equipment and then more electronic stuff. Also view, and it's more of the same junk.
The big old box of stuff, which is actually probably going to be bigger than the frame. Much bigger than the frame, actually. In fact, I'm going to have to take the camera off to show you the sheer magnitude of this thing.
Yep, here's my setup. There's the box. It's bigger than the whole setup here. There's a little soldering station there. It's got a hot air gun, a soldering iron, and a little power supply built in, which is all pretty cute. Some lights for things, this little magnifying glass majig that actually works pretty well if you're not looking at it through a phone camera because it doesn't understand how those kinds of things work. This is the old one. I'm still going to use it though. Soldering pump, all that stuff, little tripod microphone that I'm not going to use. Don't know what that was. Oh yeah, this weird mysterious coil of wire that came with my soldering station. I don't know what that's for. It's just like some magnet wire. If anyone knows what that's for, go ahead and, well, frankly, I don't care. All right, so let's see what lives inside. Get out my world's dullest box cutter. This blade point actually used to be sharp. If it'll work, why don't you focus on it? Come on. There we go, autofocus back on. There we go. That used to be a sharp point, I think. I think this knife actually came with the house, so it is probably the world's most expensive box, or the world's oldest and crappiest box cutter. It still kind of works, though. I hope I don't destroy whatever $1,000 rock is in here. It's packed full of stuff. Okay. Put that knife away for now. We get... What even is this? Okay. Viking Revolution beard shaping template. Oh, that's right, I gotta hold it like this. I keep forgetting. And apparently, whoever watches this video first, you can get this secret code that I frankly don't care about. You might have to tilt your phone or whatever, but there's that. I don't need it. I thought this was supposed to be like electronics. I don't know how this is open box. And more of the same. Use another secret code if you want it. If you're the first person who took the first code, please don't take this one. Be nice to the next guy. We also get... I don't even know what this thing is. What is it? It is... If I can get it open. Ew, it's got some grease on it or something. Looks like a display port to HDMI adapter. That could be useful. If I got a crappy monitor, I want to run on a good graphics card. Looks like you got another one of the same thing. Actually, no, looks like HDMI to VGA. That could actually be pretty useful. I'm gonna keep those. Next, Homsum Business Power. Looks like some type of battery. don't really have a need for this. There's the part number. If any of you need one of these things, maybe I could ship it your way. It looks like the little water detection tab has actually been triggered. So if you do want this thing, take that with a grain of salt. It may have been... someone may have scammed the seller in returning it. Next. Refrigerator water filter. What's inside? Is it a used one or a new one? Who knows? Oh, it's still sealed. Okay. It is a sealed one of these. Again, if anyone wants these, I could probably just slap these right back on eBay. I don't know. It's still sealed. I don't have anything that uses this particular type of filter. And we got another one of those, too. You know, I'm actually going to put the box on the floor. Let's put the box on the floor so I can show stuff off a little easier. Some kind of pills? Really? Skip. The label's upside down. I'm probably just going to throw these away, unless anyone knows that they're not just poison or whatever. Yeah, see? Look. This one's right side up, the other one's upside down. It's literally a factory error. That's incredible. Yeah, I'll really trust this. Looks like ear cushions for a specific type of headphone. Also comes with some plastic mounting thing. What's this? Bingle. Is that the brand name? I'm going to keep it just for that brand name alone. Next.
Let's see.
A-static. World famous radio mics. Oh, it's in French. Classic external speaker. Complete with mounting bracket, 10-foot cord, and 3.5mm plugs. Max input 5 watts.
We'll have to check that later. Looks like we got another one too for super stereo deluxe sound experience.
Well, I'll be pretty surprised. This little speaker actually sounds pretty good. Oh wait, hang on, actually, I forgot to plug it in all the way. Yeah, that's not great. It's actually overloading the USB port trying to drive it. That's incredible. Yeah, that's kind of about what I expected out of this thing.
This box looks interesting.
Actually, this looks suspiciously like one of those clone cell phone boxes. I can't make out what this says. I see telescope.
Maybe it's one of those things that... maybe it's one of those little microscopes that clips onto your phone or something. Let's turn the focus back. See what lives inside, especially for you.
What's especially for me?
Let's find out. Oh, comes in a little carry case.
Telephoto lens kit user manual. Step one, clip it in. Step two, use it.
Makes sense. It's probably going to be missing parts if it's an open box. Let's see. Oh no, looks like everything's there.
We get a cleany cloth.
The lens, which
doesn't sound like it's broken.
And we get some kind of
spring tension screw clip thing that's incredibly tight.
Oh, I see. So that would, that's like a little rubber seal that would go onto your phone case or whatever. And then this slides to adjust to different camera positions. But no matter what, it's not going to adjust far enough to fit on my Note 9. So that's kind of worthless. It turns.
and it moves when you turn it, although mechanism sounds kind of crusty. Can I look through it and see anything interesting?
No, the focal distance on this thing is ridiculous. It's really meant to be put right up against the lens. Yeah, that's a focus control. That's not a zoom control.
It does the job, though. If I stick it up against my lens, you can't see anything.
I'll have to test this properly later, but so far it seems like it might be not half decent, but maybe a third decent. Let's put that back in there.
Here we go.
Interesting.
Here's that lens. And we'll see if we can clip it onto the phone. No, that doesn't really work. It just doesn't go, I guess, like, far away enough. Oh, there we go. That kind of works. Maybe. Well, that does work a little bit. You can focus on stuff. That kind of works. I wonder if it'll work as like a microscope. How close is it? Oh, it doesn't even focus close at all. And now it's been knocked out of alignment. I mean, this thing, well, it just barely works. Get loads of like distortion and various artifacts, and it barely kind of lines up. It barely works with my particular phone. What happens if we combine the zoom on this thing with digital zoom on the phone? Answer, you just get a horrifying distorted mess. But I suppose it does technically work. If you want a true optical zoom experience for your phone, zoom in further on it and really see the detail in your weird frosted glass window. And this is what it looks like when it's completely zoomed out. Zoom in. I mean, I get the same effect if it's zoom in, but you get digital zoom, so it kind of sucks. I don't know.
A set of headphones. Cool. Are they Bluetooth or? Base. 10M remote control. Polymer battery. Okay, it's gotta be Bluetooth. That could be kind of interesting. Running the best companion. Here we go. Hi-fi, ultimate sound, special cavity, trying to look for anything great. Intelligent digital noise reduction. That's not ANC, is it? App remote operation. Splash medical material, whatever that means. Waterproof design. Response. It's this usual junk. Tally, yes, whatever that means. These look like they've never been even messed with. Oh, they come with little ear hooky things. And a little charging cable. And the world's smallest... Wow, that's all you get. That's the entire manual. Incredible! They give these a proper test later. Stick it in the end of the video or whatever. These look like something that Who's That One Guy Dank Pods would be into. Actually, I wonder if I could send him any of this junk. That'd be pretty interesting. Oh, we got the plain box. Okay, I have no clue what this is. Just a part number and void sticker. If you see void, then the box was opened. But I don't see void, so let's open it. Is it the kind that says void and you peel it off? Oh yeah, reckon the warranty that this thing doesn't have. A set of earphone pads and earplugs and this bag. This must just be a big case of stuff where people got the wrong items when they ordered things. So we got a little bag. We got these ear pads. Look like they have sticky tape. They're really soft, like a pair of Beats by Dre or something. Comes to mind first.
If I could find something that this mounts to, these would actually be really nice earphone pads. But unfortunately, I prefer the in-ear type of headphones. Maybe my headset, maybe my PC headset would work with this. I don't really know. Don't know why it comes with earplugs either. It says, your best choice. Is it a belt? It looks awfully small to be some kind of a belt. Let's see. It is a belt! Looks like it's got either a big I, or maybe a double-ended letter T on it. Don't really know what I'll use this for. I've already got enough belts as it is for work. That'll go into the I'll probably sell it on eBay a little bit later pile. Oh, this fell over. When did that happen? This thing. Lipstick. By Ebo. That's all you get. Oh, perfectly bound. Oh, no. Is this what I think it is? Okay, no, it's not what I thought it was, but it's still really interesting. Eyebrow trimmer, painless hair remover. What lives inside? Yep, it's a piece of lipstick that you recharge with a USB port. Let's not get too much into the implications of that. How... Looks more like a nose hair trimmer or something. Hang on. That's weird. So it's got this weird little cutting blade in the top. I'm guessing that is like a nose hair trimmer or something. Let's see. Okay, it doesn't twist to turn on. Press the button. That totally doesn't sound suspicious at all. Let's try it on my little mustache because I haven't shaved yet today. Ah! Oh! Ow! Freaking painless, my... It freaking jammed on my hair, and then it ripped the hair out. That's like a bit of my skin. No, this thing sucks. It's got a little light in it, I guess. But it sucks. I don't even know where this extra hair stuff goes, because it doesn't just fall out. It probably just builds up inside until it just catches fire. This is going into my teardown drawer right now. This will be pulled to bits later. Okay, next. Another set of those headphones. Nice. Japanese erasers? Wow, genuine Japanese Pentel. Looks like those plastic erasers. Yeah, high polymer erasers. They look just the same as the normal ones, but they're Japanese. Another pair of these frickin' headphones! I'm gonna have to set up like a giveaway for these or something, I don't know. Oh, this is pretty cool. Boxes beat to crap, but it's a webcam, apparently. Boxes really beat to crap. This thing is probably lost in shipping and was rejected, or it just returned to sender or whatever. What's inside? Is it even working? Oh, this thing's definitely been used. Cable's all mashed up. It does have a little inbuilt privacy shutter thing. Yeah, it's... Actually, no, that might be an add-on. Yeah, that's glued on there. I think that's some kind of add-on that somebody added to it later. I don't think it comes with that out of the box. I might set this up to... It's got one of these things, you can fold it around the monitor, and it goes all different ways. I might have to see if I can hook this up to my computer, and see if it'd be any good for stuff. Heck, maybe I can even set it up for doing these on the workbench videos, instead of using my phone all the time like I'm doing right now. Hook it up to a Raspberry Pi or something, have it film the video, or whatever. Just realize all these drawers are kind of falling out for some reason. Or maybe I could just set it up to monitor my 3D printer. Either way, it's a webcam. Don't know if it works, but it's a thing that physically exists. I was not expecting to get anything this fancy in this box. In fact, if we're anything, I'm expecting to get 16 more pairs of these headphones. This looks interesting. 50-pack of paint-grade pocket hole plugs. Oh, so that's if you have, like, a screw going in at an angle. And you know what? There are not 50 of them in here. How do you open it? Yeah, there's not. There's not 50 of them in there. There's, like, 12 left. This is a seller. This is someone that scammed the Amazon return system. They used up, like, 40 of them, and then they just returned the rest. I'm not sure if I'll find a use for these. I'm not really that much into woodworking, but the box would be good for storing, like, little screws and things. Next!
Ooh, there's a big box at the bottom that says professional. I'll have to get that at some point.
The heck? Jeez, some kind of Super China Deluxe battery that makes itself look way better than it really is. I'm still can't help but be a little bit kind of wary about keeping these batteries in my house. Oh, yeah, it's got protection, stable voltage. I thought that was a Q at first instead of a G. Warranty period for all Cameron Sinos batteries are limited to 12 months. Nah. If anyone needs this particular type of battery, again, drop me a line. Maybe I could send it your way, or put it up on eBay or whatever. Okay, I don't even... Actually, never mind. Lore Nespresso Original Line Compatible Aluminum Capsule Set of 5 Flavors Variety Pack 50 Pods. So they're like something for a Keurig machine? Something similar? What's inside? No, it's an Xbox controller? Okay! Wasn't expecting that. But greatly appreciated. Actually, if anything, it looks like it may be an Xbox One controller. Doesn't feel too horribly bad. It's got little grips on the side. It's green. I would have preferred red, but hey, beggars can't be choosers. Even not a beggar, I paid $100 for this thing. Comes with a cord. It says it's wireless. So I'm guessing... That's a nice email address. That's what it's going to look like in the future when every single known word in the English language is taken up for usernames and emails and stuff. So it's probably Bluetooth or something? That could be kind of cool, actually. How do you turn it on? Oh, it's got a button. Flashes. Now, real question is this natively compatible with, like, the Xbox? Or is it Bluetooth? We'll have to find that out later. For now, you can just go on and flash forever in your little box. Maybe if I plug in the charger, it'll shut up. No, it won't. Okay. We'll just let it time out in there. That could be interesting to play with. Clothing. There is a 0% chance that this is going to be my size, so I'm just going to throw this right away. Actually, I'm going to go ahead and turn this upside-down bottle of... totally not poison towards the camera, so you know how great it is. What is this? I thought it was playing cards at first, but no, it says Hangover Vape Pen Kit. Miracle Mint. Never have a hangover again from the ancient... I don't smoke or vape or any of this stuff. Screw cartridge to battery. Oh, it's a whole vape device in here? There's like a whole... I'm curious now. I don't do this stuff, but... I don't know. Where should I sell it? I don't know. It doesn't smell like anything. Oh, yeah. It does say, it does have the... It's a whole set in there. It has a battery and a charger in it. Is there nicotine in there? It doesn't say there's nicotine in it. No, it'd have late warning labels plastered all over it if there was nicotine in it, at least here in America. I'm gonna do some more research on this. Maybe it's safe to get without getting addicted. But I'm not gonna take my chances right here. I'll do more research. Maybe I'll sell it. I don't know. Next is a simpler thing. Digital thermometer. I've actually been looking for one of these, just a cheap little thing. Too bad it was kind of buried in a box that was worth $100, but that's got a little thermistor on the end, or a thermocouple, who knows? And it looks like it takes a couple of coin cells that, I don't know, have they run out, or is there an insulator? I don't know.
No, there's no insulator. The battery seems to have just failed over time. I don't see any insulator pieces. No, the battery's just worn out. Maybe this was returned just because the battery's failed over time. But even though it's not working now, AG13 button cells are pretty easy to come by. So I should be able to get this thing working.
And I can get my blowtorch and see how high it can read. That'd be pretty cool.
We got three of these, whatever they are.
Chelman. We got three what look like identical things. Let's open one up.
Actually, what's it say?
Doesn't really give away its secret. Chelman Ultimate Psi Fiber Leather Black.
I'm thinking smartwatch band. And we got
a wallet.
Oh, no way. Is this... Oh my gosh, I literally bought a wallet that was almost exactly like this, like a freaking month ago, for like $40, except it was red instead of black, and now I've got freaking three of them. Nice!
Oh, it's not quite the same though, it seems a lot cheaper. It's got that cheap leather smell to it.
Really cheap, like plastic synthetic leather smell. That seems to be what this is designed for, just a bunch of junk to resell. Oh, it doesn't even go like that. Whoops. Next, let's get a big thing in here.
A telephone.
At least that's what it looks like. Oh, that is incredibly cheap. Oh, it's an old school landline phone. Oh, I see what this is. This is a, I see why this one was returned.
This is broken inside.
Yeah, this thing's busted. Sounds like this, speaker?
Yeah, speaker broke loose. So that's no good.
Got a switch there. When you hang it up, it hangs up. It's got the... What? And this came in the box with it, too. What even is this?
Okay. This came in the box with the telephone, I think. Charge, Xbox, PC, optical in, USB. I don't know. Maybe it could be the receiver to that controller I got. Maybe it's not Bluetooth. Maybe this is a, this is way more interesting than this piece of broken garbage. Astro.
And this one doesn't have a brand on it at all.
But the colors are kind of the same.
I don't know. I'll have to hook this thing up to my PC, see what it says it is. For now, I'll put it in the box with the controller, because I don't know what this is for. It's probably a receiver for that controller. Maybe it just fell out of the box and ended up in the telephone bag for some reason. We get ringer on, off.
We don't even get tone or pulse dialing with this. You just, all you get, whatever you get, you get.
Telephone line.
One of the pins looks like it's broken off in there.
And this whole thing is just a hollow piece of trash. It weighs about a tenth of a gram, approximately, and it's broken inside. And there's no identifying information at all.
No label or anything, just a big mold seam.
It doesn't even have any, like, I don't know. I mean, redial, flash, it's got your number, things on it. I mean, I imagine it would work as a cheap phone if it wasn't broken inside. I'll have to pull this thing apart and see what's actually got in it.
That'd be interesting.
Just kind of jam this back into the telephone bag.
Oh, that's a little handset plugs in.
Oh, that's interesting. The little cable for the handset is ever so slightly smaller than
the cable for the normal phone line. Has that been a standard? I don't know. This thing's junk, broken. Away with you. This looks like some type of small microphone. Yes, it is indeed a... Wow. An incredibly impressively generic USB microphone. It's got your hinge. A rattly little microphone in there. Got a button to turn it on and off. No branding. USB cord. That's all you get. Actually, you know what? I'm going to splice in a quick recording of how this sounds. Okay. You can see where these came from. Walmart, originally $7.97 for high-definition photo-quality 2-pack magnet of Duck Commander. I don't understand it. I don't understand this at all. It's a magnet. Oh, it's branded, I guess. Okay, so you could have gotten Real Tree, which is some kind of company that designs camouflage for hunting and things. And then Duck Commander, which I don't know what that is. Maybe some kind of gun or ammo company. I got no idea what that one is. Either way, I got some friends up north that might like these. Bit of a sudden jump cut there, because apparently my phone decided to randomly overheat, so I had to wait for like freaking 10 minutes for it to cool down. Oh, excuse me. Also, apparently, I didn't just get three. I got 1, 2, 3, 4 of these darn things. At least it's overthrown the current leader of most amount of junk with these three pairs of headphones. A plain small white box that rattles. I'm thinking some kind of small electronic parts, maybe? What's it say? Hi-Fi King, high-end, IEC, AC, power, hi-fi, DIY. Electronic amplifier kit that you have to solder up yourself? No, it's a... What? It's a IEC plug? I have never seen one like this before. It's like an IEC plug that's like what you attach to the end of a extension cord to replace the plug-in at the end. Really weird. I mean, I suppose that makes sense. It seems like something like this would exist. I've just never seen one before. It's not a thing you would see at like a hardware store or even a micro center. Maybe it lights up or something too. I don't know, but it says the king of high fidelity, which means it's snake oil, audiophile garbage. Looks like some kind of remote control. Media remote for Xbox One Slim X. I think my little brother has one of those. Xbox One. Control Blu-ray movies, streaming video and apps on Xbox One. Turn on the TV and adjust the volume. This looks like it's been handled in the past. There's lots of little finger marks. Or it could just be imperfections in the molding. Actually, I'm going to say imperfections in the molding. I can't just wipe those off. Light's not going on. Does this come off? It says push it this way. Maybe that's why they returned it, because it couldn't get it open. No, that doesn't work. That doesn't open up. I'm guessing it would just take a couple of AAAs or something, though. I can't get it open, though. So I'm just going to throw it back in here. And maybe give it to my little brother or something. Assuming he even watches movies on his Xbox. Assuming he even plays his Xbox anymore. All I've seen him on is the PC lately. What? Reminder, bristles fade with use as a reminder to replace the toothbrushes? Oh my goodness, it's a freaking... replacement heads for an electric toothbrush that I don't have. Oh, that's real great. Yeah, compatible with handles. So the handles, you don't even get the handles. It's just replacements. That's something I could probably resell. And it looks like I get another one, too. Yep, looks like the exact same thing. Okay, what's next? There's a little blue thing. Blue is pretty consumer friendly, so maybe it's something insane. It says, ask Alexa, say it, scan it, ask Alexa. It's not an Amazon product, is it? It is! Amazon wand. Let's open it up. What is it? Is it like a little Alexa thing that you take with you instead of just using the app on the smartphone that you already have? Buy toothpaste, dark roast coffee, how many calories? It's just an Alexa device. Oh, here we go. Amazon wand is your one-stop device for everything on Amazon. Say organic blueberries or buy laundry. Wand can help you add it to your cart or buy it now at the same time. What I'm really interested in is if this thing works on automation. So is this a... Yeah, it's a barcode reader? That's kind of cool. Oh, there it is. There's the device. My gosh, it really is a little barcode reader on the end. What'll I come up with next? Comes with a couple of batteries. I guess Japanese batteries. They have the brand name in English. Duracell. They won't focus on because it's shiny and the camera hates that, I guess. Assuming a 10-year shelf life... They expire in March 2025, which means that this thing could be 5 years old? Huh. Comes with a little hook? I guess it's... Is it like a magnet? It is not a magnet. It looks like it's just adhesive. It just sticks to stuff. You can hang it on the wall or whatever. Here's the sealed Amazon wand. I've never heard of this thing, so this thing is either really new or really old. Probably the latter. A little screen protector on the camera lens, or barcode reader, whatever it is. It's got a button on it. And that's all there is to it. It looks like it's got some kind of sensor or a microphone here. Another microphone, maybe a speaker there. It says Amazon on it, and it's got this sensor. You'll need your Amazon wand, two AAA batteries included, a Wi-Fi connection, network password if required, and your phone. Open your Amazon wand by pulling it 2 hours apart. Using your phone, go to wand setup. Follow the on-screen instructions. The next item says professional on it, so it's gotta be the best. Get out of here. Over there. Yep, it says professional tripod. There's a picture of it. It's so great. Looks like you could get probably red, black, or other. I'm guessing it's the black one. Let's see. This thing looks like it's never been opened. It's got a little bag. Okay, it's not a little... Oh, it's one of those ones that you can, like, put over your shoulder. That's kind of nifty. Got... Oh, that's cool. It comes with a cell phone holder. That only looks like it supports devices that are in portrait orientation. Oh, you know what? No, that's... Oh, this is, like... It's got, like, one for a smartphone and then another for a tablet. That's actually pretty cool. Except for the part where it's already broken and a spring is coming out of it. So that's worthless. Maybe that's why they returned it. I don't see it floating in the bag either. This is just broken then, so that's worthless. And here I thought I actually got something cool out of this. Tripod. That comes with a manual. User manual. Professional photography equipment producer. That's not what a tripod is. Oh, it smells like cheap plastic in there. How to connect to the Bluetooth when it comes with one of those little clicky buttons. There must be more stuff in here then, surely. Oh yeah, we get... Looks like a GoPro adapter. Or any other camera that uses that weird type of mount. And we do indeed actually get a little clicker button. Camera 360 iOS or Android. So I'm guessing this thing just works as a Bluetooth headset without the headphones. Oh, good as this tripod. I mean, kind of weird and springy down here. doesn't really stay in place. Real question is, though, has it got the... Oh, they've kind of tried to make an effort to get one of those, like, smooth, fluid video heads. You know how, like, the video heads have, like, the fluid in them, or that grease thing, so it doesn't just creak and grind when you move it? It's kind of grindy and crusty, but it works all right. I mean, it moves sort of smoothly. This just loosens. There's no crank, it just moves up or down. Moves to a reasonable height, I suppose. I wouldn't really call it... Oh, okay, this just kind of comes out of the bottom there. All right. I wouldn't call it, like, professional grade, but for something to just have around in the trunk of your car or whatever, that might not be a bad idea for this thing. There's just a part number label on it. It's kind of light, a little bit rattly. I don't know what this could be. I legitimately have no idea. Well, there's a label on it. 3,000 watt immersion heater. Oh, no way. No way. There is no way that this is one of those heaters from Big Clive, where it's just like the two electrodes that go into the water and literally electrocute your child. There's no way that this could be one of those. It's not possible. It's gotta be one of the little curly heating elements, I'm sure of it. Immersion heater, portable water heater instructions. Ah, okay. Yeah, it does look like it's the kind that uses a little curly heating element. Although this thing, considering it's 3,000 watts, it's probably going to be 240 volts. Therefore, it would be worthless to me. But let's see what's inside of one anyway. It's got a... Man, this thing's cheap. It's got an LED that's covered in hot glue. Maybe an epoxy. There's the heating element there. And yes, indeed, there is the heating element. And that's it. That's all you get. It's got this little seal. Looks like that would do something. It's got like a little silicone ring in there that tightens down. Now, let's see. This thing says it's 3,000 watts. But it has a US plug on it, and this thing says 15 amps. 3,000 watts is more than a standard breaker can take. They can only take like 1,800. Should I just plug it in and see if we blow the breaker? Let's plug it in and see if we blow the breaker. Let's use our new and improved Workbench power supply to figure this thing out. 120 volts, 13 amps. And it's smoking. I'm gonna shut that off. That's it for this sort of mystery bag box junk video thing. I gotta figure out what I'm gonna do with 4 packs of these magnetic stickers and 3 pairs of these headphones and 2 of these weird mystery tablets that expire in March. And this weird box of wooden stuff and the speaker. I mean, I guess the speaker. But yeah, that's kind of it.